Only two worms remain on our list of species studied by Simon Conway Morris in the 1970s. Before we get to number 5, which is one of the most well-known Cambrian species, we must tackle number 4, Amiskwia. This charismatic worm continues to puzzle paleontologists to this day. Only 5 specimens of Amiskwia were found by Charles Walcott in the early 20th century, and even today, only 30 specimens have been found in the Burgess Shale, the longest a mere 25 millimeters. In his book, Wonderful Life, Stephen Jay Gould describes Amiskwia as gelatinous, a word also used to describe our flat beast Odontogryphus, but I feel it fits Amiskwia much better. Amiskwia shows no evidence of any segmentation or hard parts of any kind. It remains smooth from its round head to its flat tail, though it does have a pair of tentacles protruding from the front and 2 fins along its sides. The name Amiskwia refers to its tail, as Amiskwi is the Cree word for beaver tail and is commonly used to describe geological features of Yoho National Park where these fossils were found. The fins of Amiskwia provided the first clue about its taxonomic classification. Back in 1911, Walcott placed Amiskwia in the phylum Chaetognatha, classifying it as an arrow worm. This was based solely on the location of the fins, which match up with the general arrow worm body plan. This hypothesis was not formally questioned until the 1960s, when a paper published in the Journal of Paleontology described key differences between chaetognaths and Amiskwia, including the fact that several chaetognath characteristics were missing from the head, including hooks, teeth, and a hood. Furthermore, and most importantly, Amiskwia's gut did not match that of any extant chaetognaths. Its anus was in a completely different place. As we learned from Dinomiscus, the location of the anus is extremely telling. The paper went on to explain similarities between Amiskwia and ribbon worms, which make up the phylum Nemertea. Male ribbon worms in the genus Nectonemertes have tentacles similar to Amiskwia's, though in a different area of the body. However, the head of Amiskwia does not resemble that of Nemerteans either. When Conway Morris got his hands on Amiskwia in the 70s, he did the responsible thing and admitted that Amiskwia's characteristics cannot be attributed to a known phylum with any certainty, and any similarities to these phyla can be explained only by convergent evolution. This would place Amiskwia in its own phylum entirely. In 2019, a paper was published claiming Amiskwia as a member of the phylum Gnathostomulida, the jaw worms. Looking at the 2 side by side, I absolutely see the resemblance. How was this overlooked before? Well, Gnathostomulida was first recognized in 1956, so no one knew enough about it back then to make the connection. The paper describes how Amiskwia's jaw resembles that of the Gnathostomulids, which covers the main aspect that the other hypotheses failed to explain. The only major difference is lifestyle. Gnathostomulids live in sediment, while Amiskwia was a swimming creature. This behavior is actually what sets Amiskwia apart from other organisms of the Burgess Shale. Most animals in the Cambrian allegedly stayed close to the sea floor, either in it, on it, or right above it. Amiskwia, on the other hand, was a strong swimmer, based on its body shape and fins, which may explain why few fossils have been found, as most individuals of the genus were not caught in the mudslide that fossilized the specimens of the Burgess Shale. In Gould's words, this different mode of life would explain the great rarity of Amiskwia, Odontogryphus, and a few other creatures that may have lived in open waters above the grave. I can't help but wonder about all of the Cambrian animals who were not fossilized, even in the great Lagerstätt that is the Burgess Shale. How many other advanced organisms thrived in life before being lost to time, forgotten, their bottom-dwelling neighbors immortalized in stone? Perhaps they live on as well, swimming for all eternity in the Twilight Zone. Thank you all once again for listening. My last video was kind of a flop. I think YouTube is mad at me for taking another break, but I am back for the time being and eager to finish up this worm saga so we can get back to the arthropods. I don't want to spoil anything, but as I mentioned earlier, the next species on the list is a fan favorite, so stay tuned. For now, I want you to go outside and try your best to enjoy nature in the summer heat. Don't let the wonders of the Cambrian distract you from the beautiful ecosystems living on around us. Go catch some frogs and pet some moss, or whatever they say in Animal Crossing. I'll be around. Bye!